Another year, another disappointing Carolina Hurricanes playoff run. As soon as they play a good team, they always fold. I swear to God, they had the game in the bag in the third period up 3-1. And you guys allow, what, 4 straight goals for the Rangers to win the game? Chris Kreider gets a third period hat trick and you just absolutely sell away your season. I mean, not to mention the fact that they were already down 0-3 in the series, won 2 games in a row, and then on the verge of forcing game 7, they completely fold like the Toronto Maple Leafs. Rod Brindamore is probably out of there in the offseason, most likely. And GM Pasta now is on the job, boys. So you know the deal. We got 5 years to win this team a Stanley Cup. Can I turn around the Hurricanes and hopefully make them not sell in the playoffs any longer? So let's go ahead, take a look at the roster, see what we are working with. So obviously, I am going to be starting at the beginning of the season. So this entire year has not even played out yet. We do need to re-sign Jake Guentzel at the end of the season. 5.5 mil. He'll definitely be looking for a raise. Also, Brady Shea. Another important piece that I do want to get back to our decor. A guy like Brett Pesce would be also somebody that I want to re-sign. Seth Jarvis needs to be back also. But yeah, this team's already built pretty good. I mean, the only thing we're missing is a legit superstar. I'm sorry, Sebastian Aho, but you are not that X-factor player that the Carolina Hurricanes need in the playoffs. All right, so the first deal that I'm going to try to make here is Tage Thompson for Sebastian Aho. Straight up, Tage Thompson seems a lot better in this game. He puts up like 50 goals and 40 assists. I will see if Buffalo will take this 1-for-1 deal, and they will not, so I'm probably going to have to add in some draft picks. I will add in 2 seconds for Tage Thompson, and the Buffalo Sabres have accepted our offer. The next guy I'm going after is Logan Stankoven for Dury. A 3rd and a 4th will Dallas accept, and they have. Obviously, Stankoven will grow into a much better player, probably by year 2 or even year 3. Next up, we need to get rid of Freddie Anderson. He's on the older side. He's only making $3 million, but I mean, grabbing a guy like Spencer Knight with high elite potential will be perfect for our roster. So I'll trade that and also a 1st-round pick, Spencer Knight, and the trade has been rejected. Okay, I have to sweeten the deal just a touch here. I will add 2 seconds and another 3rd-round pick, and the trade has been accepted by Florida. So here is the new look Carolina Hurricanes. We have Guentzel, Thompson, and Natchez on the first line, Svechnikov, Kuznetsov, and Teravainen. Also a very young Kotkaniemi, Jordan Staal, and Seth Jarvis. Logan Stankoven will slot in on that 4th line very nicely with Fast and Comtois. Now defensively, I really didn't make any changes. This decor is very good, but I mean, we do need to re-sign a few of them in the offseason. If we take a look at our starting goalie, an 84 Spencer Knight, who isn't top level yet. I think Freddie Anderson was like an 85, 87, but in a few seasons, he will 100% grow into probably like an 88, maybe even a 90 overall goaltender. And of course, we only have 5 years to win a Stanley Cup, so we are in win now mode at the moment here in Carolina as we are hunting for a Stanley Cup. GM Pasta is on the job. He's been cooking. Now, if you guys do enjoy videos like this, make sure you leave a like and subscribe to the channel. Turn on notifications so you get notified when I go live or when I post a video. So at the end of the year, Carolina is going to have a very good regular season. 51-24-7, 109 points, 2nd in our division, only behind the Rangers, who eventually won the President's Trophy. We were the 2nd best team in the entire league. And this is exactly what I'm talking about. Tage Thompson leading our team, 44 goals, 90 points. Jake Guentzel put up almost a 50 goal season as well. I want to re-sign this man. 88 points, a career high. Marty Natchez at 78, Svechnikov 65, also at 27 goals. Kuznetsov had 62, Teravainen 60, D'Angelo 48, and Spencer Knight went 30-19-6. 2 shutouts and a .904 save percentage. If we take a look at the entire NHL, Matthews is going to end up leading in goals with 61 and points with 109, followed by McKinnon, who had 108. McDavid was up there. Nylander had a good season. Draisaitl and Rantanen. Also, shout out to Carlson and Fox, both putting up over 100 points as a defenseman. And for goals, obviously Matthews led, but Pasternak and Kaprizov both had a 50 goal season, and Jake the Bake. If we take a look at goals, Pasternak and Kaprizov both had a 50 goal season, and Jake the Snake almost did as well. 49 on the season. He's only 29 years old as well. I definitely am going to have to re-sign him at whatever dollar he is asking for. And in the first round of the playoffs, we are up against the New Jersey Devils, who have 0 goaltending, so we should be able to score at will against them. We took care of business in round number 1, dominating the Devils in 5 games, and now we're up against the defense-heavy New York Islanders, who are literally allergic to scoring, but somehow swept their opposition in the first round. We would end up beating them in 6 games, and now we have the Boston Bruins in the conference final. Finals. We know Carolina has not won a Conference Finals game in a very long time, so hopefully we do not get swept. And finally, since 2006, the Carolina Hurricanes have made the Stanley Cup Finals. We won a clutch Game 7 victory against Boston in the Conference Finals. And now we're up against the Winnipeg Jets, who do have a very good team that simulates pretty well in this game. So let's see if we can go on. Finally, we got over the hump, but now is it time for the Carolina Hurricanes to take home the Stanley Cup. For the first time since 2006, the Carolina Hurricanes are Stanley Cup champions in one season. GM Pasta has got Carolina not only over the hump in the Conference Finals and not being swept, but also winning the goddamn Stanley Cup. And I mean, I don't want to take too much credit for it. This team was already built pretty good. But I mean, I did make a major move moving Aho for Tage Thompson, which I mean, turned out to be the greatest trade ever in Hurricanes history. Marty Nature's Conn Smythe winner, 10 goals, 31 points. I mean, this series was back and forth. Marty Nature's was steady throughout the entire playoff run. Definitely well-deserved for the Hurricanes, as there it is, the Stanley Cup about to be raised in Raleigh, North Carolina. I believe it's North Carolina, I could be wrong. As here comes our captain, Jordan Staal, for the second time in his career, coming to lift the Stanley Cup. First as a captain, though, and first with the Carolina Hurricanes, as we have gone all the way here in year number one. We got over the hump that we needed to. Rod Brind'Amour gets to keep his job, and GM Pasta now is a legend in Carolina. Now, I am a little unsure why Marty Nečas got the Conn Smythe trophy, considering Tage Thompson had 16 goals and 32 points. Nečas did have 31, though. Kuznetsov had a very good playoff run. 28, Teuvo Teravainen 27, Jake Guentzel 26, and Svechnikov 22. So, I mean, we had like 7 players score over 22 points in the postseason. That is literally unheard of. We had the best offense in the entire playoffs. Matthews is going to take home the Ted Lindsay, Maurice Richard, Art Ross, and Hart Trophy. The Norris to Adam Fox. The Conn Smythe to Martin Nečas. Igor will win the Vezina. And the Selke will end up going to Sidney Crosby. So here we are in the offseason. We have $22 million in cap space. And we need to re-sign guys like Jake Guentzel, Seth Jarvis, Brady Shea, Teuvo Teravainen, and Brett Pesce. I would like to take all of these guys back. I don't know if we have the cap for it, though, honestly. So we might end up letting these guys walk to free agency. A guy like Dmitry Orlov I could move off of. He's making $7.2 million for a 32-year-old that's 82 overall. That is a very high cap hit. So he is most likely gone in the offseason. Thankfully, we did get Brady Shea re-signed. Jake Guentzel rejected our offer at this dollar value, so I will have to give him a slightly larger contract. And Seth Jarvis also re-signed to our roster. I gave Jake $9.4 million, and he accepted that offer, so he's back for 4 more years, I believe. Actually, no, 7 more years. A very long contract for Guentzel here in Carolina. We also got Teuvo Teravainen back on a very good contract for $5.5 mil. So here we are in free agency. We don't have a lot of money to spend, barely $1 million. So we're not going to be going after any free agents. Obviously, Brett Pesce will have to walk. He's asking for nearly $6 million at an 84 overall. All right, so heading into season number 2, we were pretty much rolling out the exact same roster. We are running it back. Our first line, absolutely dynamic. I mean, Nečas is up to a 90. Guentzel as well. Seth Jarvis is already an 89 overall, and Svechnikov is a 90 himself. We got Teravainen on the third line. Stankoven's still a 79. Hopefully he can grow a little bit more. Why is his picture so goddamn blurry? We also have Kotkaniemi, Comtois, Staal, and Fast on the fourth line. Now, defensively, we do take a little bit of a hit. Obviously, Orlov is not really a great defender anymore, 82 overall, and Morrow is our sixth defenseman at a 79 overall. We still have Burns, Shea, Slavin, and D'Angelo, and in goal, we are rocking with an 86 overall Spencer Knight, so he's even better than he was last season. And Kochekov has grown to an 86 as well. These guys might end up splitting the games, honestly. I believe it is time to move off Dmitry Orlov's awful contract. $7.2 million, a fourth, a sixth, and another fourth for Colin Miller and Eric Halla. Will Buffalo accept the offer? And they have. So we bolster our defense, and we also grab another forward, which, I mean, we don't really need, but it makes our forward core even better. It is also a new era here in Carolina. Jordan Staal is most likely going to retire, so Tage Thompson is the newest captain alongside Jake Guentzel, who gets an A, and Jacob Slavin on the back end also gets one as well. So here we are at the trade deadline, and we are 35-20-7. I'm going to be going after Michael Matheson. He is an 87 overall, 2 years left on his deal for Morrow, a first, a seventh, a fifth, and a sixth round pick, and the Montreal Canadiens have no idea how badly I just fleeced them. I mean, they did get a first-round pick out of it, but still, We are trying to go for Stanley Cups here, not first round picks. Yet again, at the end of the season, we are going to finish second in the Metro. We went 47-26-9, 103 points, still behind the Rangers in the Metro. And the Edmonton Oilers were the best team in the entire NHL with 54 wins, followed by the Rangers, Colorado, Toronto, and Winnipeg, also Carolina, top six. Tage Thompson is going to have another great season, 37 goals, 85 points. Svechnikov at 84 and 38 goals. Seth Jarvis had a big season. Kuznetsov is still producing at 32. Jake Gensel had a bit of a step back. 32 goals, 74 points. Marty Natchez at 72. D'Angelo, 63. And Teravainen, 50. Now for our goalie, Kochekov actually started a majority of the season rocking a 902 saber center. Spencer Knight was technically better, but he played like half the games almost. He's at an 86, and Kochekov also is an 86. So we are in a goalie controversy here. Who's going to be our starting goalie of the future? 25 and 23 years old. Now for the entire NHL, again, Matthews is going to lead in goals with 57 and points with 103. Nathan McKinnon also at 103, Pasta 96, Draisaitl 95, and Kucherov also 95. And for the first round of the playoffs, we are up against the Philadelphia Flyers, who finally made it for the first time in a few seasons, so they do not have the experience that we have. We also probably have a much better roster. We should be able to at least make the conference finals. Somehow the Flyers are going to beat us in game 7, 8-3 in the very first round, as the Edmonton Oilers would go on and dominate the Flyers, who made the Stanley Cup Finals in 5 games. Shout out to McDavid for finally getting the job done. Matthews again is going to dominate all the awards. Evan Bouchard is going to win the Norris. The Conn Smythe will go to McDavid. Connor Hellebuck the Vezina, and the Selke back to Sidney Crosby for the second straight season. Now in the re-sign phase, we do have 20 mil in cap space, but we got to get back Slavin, Natchez, D'Angelo, and Kuznetsov. Also a guy like Brent Burns, who's 40 years old. I would like to bring him back for another season. Maxime Comtois, we'll probably let him walk. Actually, I'm going to qualify him for an RFA so we can get free picks. But first up is definitely, where is he at? Marty Natchez, 89 overall, 26 years old. We have to get him back. Brent Burns has decided to re-sign. Kuznetsov rejected our offer. Jacob Slavin re-signed. So here we are in free agency. Marty Natchez, of course, is on the board. He's asking for $9.2 million. I qualified him as an RFA, hoping that his value will go down and he will want like an $8.5 million deal. We can definitely afford that. And it looks like Natchez is extremely happy to accept my offer. Now, heading into our third season as the GM, this is what our forward core is looking like. Thompson now is up to a 92. Svechnikov is a 91, while Seth Jarvis is a 90. We also have Kotkaniemi, Marty Natchez, and Jake Gensel on the second line. Teravainen, Staal, and Logan Stankoven on the third line. And then we have Blake, Halla, and Comtois. Now, defensively, Jacob Slavin and Michael Matheson, I would like to put up as our first line D pair, with Brent Burns and Jeff Petrie, also Brady Shea and Colin Miller. Brady Shea, actually, I would much rather if you played top 4 minutes, while Petrie, you could be a top 60 man. And in goal, we have the best goaltending tandem with an 89 Spencer Knight and 87 Kochekov. So I think we are going to move off Kochekov, considering Spencer Knight is younger and already is better, and I want him to grow even higher than an 89. So we'll give up him, Rykov, a first and a second for David Reinbacher and Caden Primo from Montreal. And the trade has been rejected. Totally unwilling. I might have to slot in another first round pick to ensure that they take this offer. So I will give them 2 firsts, a second, Rykov and Kochekov for Reinbacher and Primo, and it's still rejected. So instead, I think I will just go along with the simulation of the season. I don't believe we're going to be able to move Kochekov for a number one D-man. And I'm not giving up Spencer Knight. So I'm pretty confident in this roster that we can make the playoffs and go on another deep run. I don't know what happened in round number one last year. We really choked. Okay, so this might sound like an absolutely horrible trade. Kotkaniemi for Sidney Crosby, straight up. Crosby is like 38, 39 years old, but he doesn't tend to retire until he's like 40 or at least 41. And we are in a time crunch here. Let's see. 1-for-1. Pittsburgh did accept our offer. They got a young guy, and we got a windmill guy and Sid the Kid, the ultimate leader. So we have Crosby slotting in on that second line very perfectly, 88 overall, with Gensel and Marty Natchez. So we brought back the duo of Crosby and Gensel on the Canes. Now, at the end of the season, we are obviously going to make the playoffs. We went 43-30-9, 95 points. And in the entire NHL, the Edmonton Oilers were the President's Trophy winners. Crosby is going to lead our team in scoring with 75, followed by Tage Thompson, who had 73, also 41 goals. Seth Jarvis at 65, Marty Nature 64, Gensel 62, and a damn near 40 goal season himself. If we take a look at Spencer Knight, 31, 23, and 4, 6 shutouts and only a 900 save percentage. So overall, I would like him to be a little bit better than that. I mean, Kochekov did okay himself, only a 906. Quinn Hughes is going to lead the NHL in scoring. Nobody even had over 100 points this season. I have no idea what's going on in the NHL. Barkov at 92, Kaprizov 91, Sam Reinhart 91. Where's McDavid, Matthews, Draisaitl? 88 and 89 points. Are you kidding me? For goals, Matthews still will have a 50 goal season, 51 on the year. Kaprizov 48, Mishkov 43, and Cousins 42. And in the first round of the playoffs, we are up against the Buffalo Sabres. For anyone who forgets, we traded Thompson for Aho, 1-for-1, so this should be a very heated series. This is a series we literally got to win. If we don't, we look kind of embarrassing, the fact that we traded away Aho and then he beats us 2 years later. This has got to be the most dysfunctional series I've ever seen. We fall down 3-0 to Buffalo, claw our way back, and lose in game 7 overtime, 6-5. Oh, the embarrassment in Carolina is unbelievable. Funny enough, Buffalo would actually go on and win the Stanley Cup, beating Vancouver in Game 7 of the Finals. Quinn Hughes is going to take them the Ted Lindsay, Art Ross, and Hart Trophy. Also the Norris, while Austin Matthews will win the Maurice Richard. Sebastian Aho wins the Conn Smythe Trophy. Are you kidding me? Stuart Skinner, the Vezina, and the Selke will go to Elias Pettersson. Now in the offseason, luckily we do almost have $30 million in cap space. We should be able to get everybody re-signed, including Seth Jarvis, who's a 90 overall at 24 years old. We also got to get back Spencer Knight, who will want a big boy contract. So Colin Miller couldn't sign because we don't have any cap space. Brent Burns, no cap space. Maxime Comtois is back. Maxime Comtois has rejected our offer. Seth Jarvis renewed. Spencer Knight is back. Michael Matheson is back. And Sidney Crosby is back. Also Logan Stankoven. We don't really have any cap space to sign anybody in free agency. Only $1.8 million. So we're pretty much just going to simulate until the regular season. Brad Marchand at 38 years old is asking for a $10 million deal. Man, the contracts in this game are absolutely wild. I've never seen anything like it. Yeah, we pretty much have the same exact team besides Crosby dropping down to an 85, so maybe that trade wasn't a great one to make. Still have Gensel and Natchez on the second line. Stankoven's up to an 84. Stahl is still there somehow. Defensively, we are hurting a little bit, but I am going to put Matheson up on the first line with Slavin. Brady Shea can play top 4 minutes alongside Calvin DeHaan. And then we have Jeff Petrie and Niskanen now in goal. 89 Spencer Knight, 87 Kochekov should be very viable, at least for the regular season. Now, at the end of year number 4, we are just barely going to squeak into the playoffs. 92 points, 41, 31, and 10. Obviously, the New York Islanders were very close to catching us, but luckily we made it. Now, for the entire NHL, the Minnesota Wild are going to win the President's Trophy. Tage Thompson, another great season, 43 goals, 80 points. Jacob Slavin had 66 as a defensive defenseman, which is crazy. Svechnikov 65, Jarvis 63, Gensel only 62, and Crosby 62 as well. Spencer Knight 28, 24, and 6, 2 shutouts, not really great stats. He is not simulated well whatsoever, so maybe he was not the goalie to go after. He is an 89 overall. And in the first round of the playoffs, the Hurricanes are up against the New Jersey Devils. I have absolutely no goddamn clue how we got swept by the goddamn Devils in the first round. Regardless, Seattle would go on to win the Stanley Cup in 5 games, and the Hurricanes now only have one more year with GM Pasta. We gotta go all in. We haven't got out of the first round since we won the goddamn Stanley Cup. Pettersson is going to win the Ted Lindsay and Hart Trophy, the Art Ross to Pasta, Maurice Richard to Austin Matthews, the Norris will go to Erik Karlsson, Shane Wright is going to win the Conn Smythe, Stuart Skinner the Vezina, and the Selke will go to Barkov. So we don't really have that much cap space, only $13 million. We do need to re-sign Brady Shea at an 85 overall. Also Niskanen, I think his name is. Regardless, we got to get him back. And if we want, we have to re-sign Kochek off, which he will probably want a big boy contract. I mean, let's take a look here. Asking for 5.3 mil, which is not terrible, but we don't have the most cap space available. Luckily, we did get Brady Shea to re-sign as well as Kochekov. And here we are in free agency with only $3.4 million to spend. I might go after a lower end player here as we don't have any cap space anyways for anybody that's decent. And we got Mason Marchman signed to a $3.3 million deal, I believe, for only one season. Now, in our fifth and final season, our first line is still absolutely stacked, but we got Crosby as an 83 overall second line centerman. That's not great, but luckily he will get carried by his wingers, Natchez and Gensel. Third line, we got Teravainen, Blake, and Stankoven. Fourth line is pretty good as well. Now, defensively, we are really hurting on defense. I mean, everybody else is like a 78 overall besides Matheson, Slavin, Shea. Not the greatest decor, but luckily we're backed by the two best goalies or the best goalie tandem in the entire league, an 89 Spencer Knight and 87 Kochekov. And we are going to see if Carolina can go on and win their second Stanley Cup of the video. If not, I still completed the challenge. So here we are at the trade deadline, 36-20-6. I want to get rid of Kochekov for Patrick Laine and Malcolm Subban. I got a first, a second, and a third, and the trade has been rejected. They don't want to retain salary. Nobody ever wants to retain salary in this game. I swear to God, you guys are way below the cap, San Jose. Instead, I will be adding Blake to the mix here. Let's see, will the San Jose Sharks do it? And they have. We picked up an absolute sniper in Patrick Laine, which should help bolster our offense even more. So here is the new look Carolina Hurricanes. We have Laine, Thompson, and Natchez on the first line. Gensel, Jarvis, and Svechnikov. Stankoven, Crosby, Marchment. And our fourth line is very nice as well. Of course, we did end up trading Kochekov, but an 89 Spencer Knight as a starter, he should be able to carry us all the way. He was the starter when we won the Stanley Cup in season number one. So at the end of the final season, we would end up finishing first in the Metro, 48-28-6, 102 points for the entire NHL. We were top five, Buffalo being the best at 53 wins. Jake Gensel is going to have a monster season, 56 goals, 86 points, followed by Tage Thompson, who had 83, Jarvis, 80. Crosby at 76, Natchez 70. Patrick Laine only had 32 goals and 59 points. I believe the Columbus Blue Jackets, actually the San Jose Sharks, who were a god-awful team. And for our goalie, Spencer Knight, 38-18-4, four shutouts and pretty good stats, a 912 save percentage. I can live with that. If we take a look at the entire NHL, Austin Matthews will dominate. 81 goals, 128 points. And we have the Montreal, les Canadiens, in the first round of the playoffs. All serious, though, we have not been out of the first round since we won the Stanley Cup, so we need a very deep playoff run here. This is our final season of the video. Let's see if we can win our second Stanley Cup. Thankfully, we did squeak out a Game 7 victory, and now we're up against the New York Rangers in round number 2. And sadly, we are only going to end up winning one Stanley Cup in the video. The Rangers dominated us in the second round, and Vancouver would end up going on and beating Buffalo in Game 7 to take home the Stanley Cup. Matthews is going to dominate all the awards. Quinn Hughes will win the Norris, the Conn Smythe to Elias Pettersson. Schmidt will win the Vezina, and Nico Hischier on the Calgary Flames is going to take home the Selke. And that will do it for this video, boys. We have gone ahead and we completed the challenge in season number 1 as we won the Carolina Hurricanes a Stanley Cup. Sadly, after that, though, we didn't make it out of the first round for 3 years, and then finally this season we lost in round number 2. So not a lot of playoff success in Carolina outside of the first season, but it doesn't matter. I'm sure Carolina Hurricanes fans are happy that they even got a Stanley Cup. So let me know in the comments what you would like to see next. Thank you all for watching, and until next time, don't be silly. Wrap your willy.